out there on YouTube. I am Robert Seidelman. This is time for another edition of the Games of 90. Well, here it is. A show a lot of people have been asking me to talk about. It's finally here. It birthed game show garbage. It gave us two monumental things in game show history. I am talking about the 1990 revival of Tic Tac Dough.
In a moment, the game that intrigued a nation. In a moment, the game of strategy, knowledge, and fun. In a moment, Tic Tac Dough! And now, our host, who will guide us through the next 30 minutes of Tic Tac Dough, Patrick Wayne! Oh, great, thank you. That's very nice. Well, good, and welcome to our show. On our last show, we just began a game between our two players, so let's meet them right now. Larry?
Yeah, it's this one. The show that gave revivals of classic properties a really bad name is finally getting its just due. Hosted by the patron saint of game show garbage, Patrick Wayne, this version of the show debuted alongside The Joker's Wild on September 10th, 1990 in most markets. Just like its sister show in The Joker's Wild, this too was scuttled off into bad time slots because of a glut in the market. Unlike The Joker's Wild, however, the critical response for this show was met with more ire than any other game show that debuted in 1990. Also, unlike The Joker's Wild, this show got canned in March of 1991 instead of getting a full year. Mm-hmm. Now, usually for a revival, I'll take a look at both the original show and the revival and see what the revival got right and see what the revival got wrong. I'm not doing that because, obviously, Tic Tac Dough 90 is awful and they got almost everything wrong. So, let's just take a look at it on its own. And what better way to start than the man himself?
Welcome to our show. Tic Tac is back. We've made several changes, and I know you're going to like them.
There he is, ladies and gentlemen, our hero, Patrick Wayne, the man most people consider to be the worst game show host in the history of television. Hell, I should know. I opened up Game Show Garbage for him as the very first induction. Man, am I glad the site looks better than it did in 2009. Anyway, everything that I complained about him in 1,000 words, I will try to summarize in about 30. Ready? Okay. He was monotonous, fake, took too long to explain the rules of the bonus game, was overexcited over a simple block or winning the game, and was overall just plain bad. Art James said it best in an interview, Patrick Wayne was an announcer playing a game show host. Patrick definitely earned that legend of being the worst host ever. But I gotta wonder, is there a host worse than him? Well, after doing game show garbage and trying to answer that question, I could only think of four off the top of my head. There's Blake Emmons, who did the new Chain Reaction. There's gotta be others out there. Blake Emmons is the only one coming to mind. I know I said four, but there's gotta be four worse than Patrick Wayne. Maybe Ross the Intern for Big Saturday Night, but do you really count that as a game show? I don't know. Leave a comment. Tell me, are there any hosts out there worse than Patrick Wayne? Or maybe worse than Blake Emmons, because he sucked worse than Patrick Wayne. Now we get to the gameplay of Tic Tac Dough. If you've seen the Wink Martindale Jim Caldwell episodes, then you are fine, because that's basically the same format they use, just with a few kinks and more money. So the board being shuffled automatically, the contestants now stop the shuffle by hitting their buzzers. I really don't have a problem with that, since it allows the contestants to control their own destiny. Somewhat. And just like Jim Caldwell,
in red are special categories that involve both of you. I'll explain how they're played when we come to them.
Yeah, Patrick said that a lot. A lot of people actually like the game itself, but what they don't like is this little rule. When there is a tie game, instead of the pot carrying over to the next game, the pot resets and the stakes get increased by $500 for each outside box and $1,000 for the center box. This leads to a gluttony of problems, mainly because the next game can be worth less than the first game. First game can be worth, at max, $5,000, but the next game can be worth, at minimum, $3,000, and this has happened a few times. It doesn't reward good gameplay at all for having a tie game. It just smacks of budget saving and then end-right sucking. Another complaint that I do hear about Tic Tac Dough 90 is that the question material is a little easy. But But then again, the original Tic Tac Dough with Wink Martindale and Jim Caldwell, their material was always a little bit easy too. So that argument's pretty much a wash right there. Now we get to the bonus game. And I only have two words for you. Rapping Dragon!
You can play good, you can play long. If you pick the dragon, all you got to be gone.
Oh, and...
We're doing the bonus game. Let me remind you what our Rapping Dragon looks like. Take a look.
Don't do, can't do, won't do. If you do, you'll be through. Yeah.
I hate this. Save me, Kurt Hennig!
I like country music. I love country girls. I like Willie Nelson. And don't forget about Pearl. There's only one thing that I hate, cause it's a bunch of crap. I hate rap.
God bless you, Kurt Hennig and the West Texas Rednecks. Thank you, Barry Windham. Thank you, Kendall Windham. Thank you, Bobby Duncan Jr. Seriously, they were the best thing in WCW in 1999. Hands down. But to be fair, the Dragon didn't always rap. This was a mid-season addition, about 6 weeks in, try to be hip to the young demographic out there because rap was big in 1990. Dead Entering sucks! And when I wrote about the Rapping Dragon on Game Show Garbage, I did say it had a great roar that instilled fear in me when I was 7 years old watching the reruns of USA. Here's the Dragon roar. And for equal time, I better do the Rapping Dragon Slayer.
And our Dragon Slayer.
Say yay, say hurrah, say hooray. If you pick the Dragon Slayer, I'll double your pay.
That's the truth.
Fuck you, Dan Enright. Anyway, the bonus game has changed from the Barry Enright trope of get to X before hitting Y, thankfully. Instead, it's the formula of get X or Z before hitting Y. Yay! After the Dragon and Dragon Slayer rap, or roar and fanfare, X's and O's shuffle, and the contestants manually stop the shuffle by hitting some sort of light device you see in an underground tunnel and late-night road construction. Okay. What the contestants must do is select either to play with the X's or the O's and make tic-tac-dough by selecting numbers off the board. For the first X or O they get is $500. Any of those afterwards doubles the money. If they do get tic-tac-dough or find the Dragon Slayer, they double the pot plus get a prize package between $2,200 and $3,500. They upped the amounts of cash in the front game, but kept the same amount for the prize packages from the old version, and instead focused more on cash. Which is okay, but the prizes were crap, and I never really did like the fact you could win more in the front game, with no tie games, than you could in the bonus game. Oh boy. That part was always very disjointed and reminded me why I hated Dan Enright as a producer. As for the bonus game, I like it just a little bit more than the original, but it's mainly a wash. And that's all for the revival of Tic-Tac-Dough 90. There is one more thing that I have to talk about when it comes to Tic-Tac-Dough 90, but I'm going to save that for an induction in a couple of weeks. Let's just say it helped birth one of the more well-known special weeks off of Richard Karn and John O'Hurley's Family Feud. But it did not change the fact whatsoever that this version sucked! The set was sparse, the host is one of the worst of all time, the front game was okay but got messed up payout-wise with the tie games resetting the pot, and the bonus game's the same old trope done to death again. This would get canceled in 6 months and reran for 2 years on USA. The tapes never be seen again. And I think everybody can be thankful for that. It was easy to see why this only lasted 70 episodes before getting axed in March of 1991. And who is to blame for this? Dan Enright! Dan Enright, you suck! Your shows suck! 1990 sucked for you! And everything that you've done after Jack Barry died sucked! I even thought pay cards, the original pay card, sucked. All About Faces suck. You just suck. And I'm not even talking about the quiz show scandals, because you jackass, you almost killed television. I'll be back in December. We'll talk about the Quiz Kids Challenge. Or Happy Show. and hopefully one that won't piss me off. I'm Robert Seidelman. See you next time.